Hey there, welcome to Five Facts with Danny. That's me, I'm Danny. And I am filming this on the very last day of August. It's hot, it's summery, and it's hard to believe that fall is just around the corner. But right now, there are birds all over the place who are currently gearing up for what fall means for them. And what fall means for them is migration. Now, when I think of fall migration, there is one quintessential bird species that always comes to mind. And we're gonna be seeing and hearing a lot of them in the very near future. So today, I wanna share with you five facts about the Canada goose. Here we go. Fact number one, there is a subspecies of the Canada goose called the giant Canada goose. Now, scientific name for Canada goose, Branta canadensis, pretty straightforward. Branta means goose, canadensis means Canada, but the subspecies name is Brantus canadensis maxima. Again, pretty straightforward why the giant Canada goose would have that addition to its name. Now, if like me, you are currently dreaming visions of giant Godzilla-like geese terrorizing the villages, unfortunately, that's not the case. The giant Canada goose is only a little bit larger than the regular, more common Canada goose species. And honestly, it sometimes is hard to distinguish them. There are a couple clues you can look for though. First and foremost, their honk is going to be a little bit lower in pitch than the average Canada goose. They also have a longer beak to body proportion, and the black on their neck starts a little bit further up than on the regular Canada goose. If you ever find yourself faced with that age-old question of would you rather fight 100 regular-sized giant Canada goose or one giant-sized regular Canada goose, you're gonna wanna go with the one giant-sized regular Canada goose because again, the difference is pretty negligible. Fact number two. Canada goose, as you probably know, is one of the most well-adapted animals to human populations. That's why we see so many of them all the time. And the reason for that is that their habitat requirements are pretty much just an open field plus water. That's all they need. And us humans have created a lot of those open fields for them. So if you think about like soccer fields, golf courses, right here where I'm standing in Estabrook Park is actually great habitat for Canada goose because there's lots of open space. Plus there's the lagoon right here. There's the Milwaukee River just over that way. And that's all they need. They love that open field because that means that when they're sitting on their nest, they can see for a long ways to see if any predators are coming. So it's really a safety thing. So if you ever find yourself annoyed that a field that you're spending time in is just full of Canada geese, really that's on us. We created that perfect habitat for them and they're just taking advantage of that. Fact number three, Canada geese do something called assortative mating. And so what that means is that when they're looking for a mate, one of the number one factors that they're looking to match up with someone is if that goose is similar in size to them. So there's a pretty wide range of size of Canada geese. However, when a male and a female are looking to mate with each other, they're gonna look for the geese that are most similar in size to them. Fact number four, Canada geese are family birds. So once the male and female have found each other and they've mated, they are typically gonna stay together throughout the season, if not further. So oftentimes in the springtime, when you see a group of geese, you'll see two adults and a whole lot of little babies and then eventually teenage geese. That is probably the mated male and female and all of their little goslings. They stick together throughout that season. And even in the fall, when you see a group of geese flying overhead migrating south, odds are that that is a family unit. Again, probably two parents and their little geese, or if it's a really large group, two or three or more families that have joined together to do that migration together. So they're really family-oriented birds, which is really sweet, isn't it? And fact number five. That infamous V formation that geese fly in when they're doing their fall migration, the reason for that V is because it's an energy-saving maneuver. When they fly in the specific V formation, what happens is that one goose flapping its wings creates an updraft that the goose behind it is able to then ride and not have to flap its wings as hard, not have to use as much energy. In fact, each of the geese that are flying behind another goose in this V formation could save up to 70% of the amount of energy that they would be otherwise using. So that goose in front, that goose is doing all the work, but don't worry because geese, when they're flying, they always are rotating in and out of position. So they're all taking equal turns up at that front spot, which is where they're expending the most energy. So the next time you see that V formation flying ahead as geese are flying south for the winter, just think to yourself how cool it is that they're all working together to find the most efficient way possible to get to their destination. And there you have it, our five facts about the Canada goose. So, Fall migration is upon us. We're gonna be seeing a lot of Canada geese in the next few months flying overhead, covering all our fields. And before you get frustrated with them and before you get scared of them, think about how they're just doing everything they can to survive and thrive in this world that we're sharing with them. So be on the lookout for those geese. Have a great fall migration, and we'll see you for the next one. Bye.